Hello and greetings from Iceland. This is it. The eruption has started just around 2 hours ago. And I decided to hold on with this update until I would get a clear view of what's going on, since this looked extremely bad when it started and still does, actually. The erupting fissure is 3.5 kilometers long now. And the lava flow is estimated to be over 100 cubic meters per second. So we are talking about by far the largest eruption that we have seen on the Reykjanes Peninsula since this volcanic chapter started in 2021. And the fissure has been growing longer and longer tonight, so this might get worse. The location from the map is just around here, or by the old Sundanhukar craters. It has to be good news that the fissure seems to be extending to the north, but the bad news is that the south part of it stretches over a little hill, and the material that is surging up on that part of it can flow directly into the town Grindavík. So we hope that this will grow to the northeast like it has been doing tonight. And when I look at my drone videos, this is approximately where the fissure is. And from here, most of the lava will flow to the north and the northeast. And it is at this northeast side where we have new barriers, lava barriers, and we are hoping that they will hold. And if they do, the rest of the lava will flow to the north, where it can do no harm. But as for the town, it is empty now. The workers who have been working at the lava barriers, they are safe. And my guess is that their next task will be to make some barriers to protect the town. And at this point in time, it looks worse for the town rather than the power plant and the Blue Lagoon, where the barriers are helping. But due to how powerful this eruption is, we don't know if they will hold. It's impossible to say at this point. So this could very easily end up with a major disaster, since it's so much lava that's coming up from there. This is not a tourist eruption. This has not interrupted any flights to Keflavik International Airport so far, but the wind is working with us tonight, and we see a lot of gas coming up from there, so we are waiting for more information about that, and it will be impossible to get close to this area for days. But I do have a long-range drone with zoom, and I have also a super zoom camera, so I can work around the drone ban that we are dealing with here, and after this upload, I'm going to pack my things and driving to Reykjavik most likely tonight or very, very early tomorrow morning, so I can cover this as well as I can. So as always, channel support is appreciated, and I want to tell you about another video that I uploaded tonight just before the eruption came up, and I was correcting the auto subtitles when a friend called me and told me about this, but it contains a lot of good information like what could trigger this eruption, and it came out like that. Proved one expert right, but another wrong. But that's just how things have been around here. So if you are thirsty for information, it's here for the full story. But the most important task now is to get some high quality footage that I can use while I describe this major event in the history of Iceland, when over a 3 kilometer long fissure is opening up in the backyard of Grindavík, that was a home of 3,800 people until November 10th, an event that seems large enough to drown the town and the Blue Lagoon and the power plant. But as for eruptions, they start often very powerful and fade out by time, so we might be more optimistic tomorrow. But tonight, this looks very bad for the people of Grindavík that actually expected to be allowed to go home in 2 or 3 days. As I was talking about in the update, that is not as valid as it was 3 hours ago. And if there will be any big changes in the next hours, I will add that to the video description, along with information about my whereabouts, when I will be in Reykjavik filming, and when to expect my next upload. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.